How's it going, guys, and welcome back to another player review. And we have a legend today to take a look at, and it is Michael Owen, and he cost me 600,000 coins. So I'd really appreciate you guys dropping a like, and if there are any other players you'd like me to take a look at, drop them in the comments. And if you are needing Ultimate Team coins to purchase any legends yourself, head over to FIFAUltimateTeamCoins.com. They're safe, automated, and reliable. User code Fuji for a discount, or if you're needing game codes, check out G2A. Links will be found in the description. But Michael Owen, let's get into it. So I first was playing Owen in a 4-3-3 formation, and for some reason he was getting lost. So then I decided to change it up to a 4-3-2-1, and exactly the same. So eventually I decided to use the 4-3-1-2 formation and help him up top with another striker, and it was working a lot better. Now the stats on his card: he's got 89 pace, 85 shot, 67 passing, 86 dribbling, 22 defense, and 64 physical. So in total I played 7 games, only scoring 7 goals, and I didn't receive any assists. But his in-game stats are pretty nice: 90 finishing, 88 dribbling, 88 volleys, 90 reactions. And as you know, Michael Owen back in the day was lightning quick, and he does feel very, very fast in game. Unfortunately, he doesn't have 4-star skills, but he's got the 4-star weak foot, so I guess that's a plus you can take. But if you want to pause the video and check out his stats, then please feel free to do that. But we want to see what he's like in game. Let's go. So when you're spending 600,000 coins on a player, you are going to want them to perform out of this world. And Michael Owen, there is something about the card that I really disliked, and in fact, I wouldn't ever purchase him again, but let's get to it. So in terms of him creating space for himself, he has medium work rates, and if you don't use the instructions to tell him either to drift wide or get in behind the defenders, he pretty much becomes useless, because his height, he's not the tallest, he's not the strongest, he's dribbling, he doesn't have the 4-star skills to get out of those like awkward situations, and his ball control, yes, it's good and you can dribble past players, but it's not someone that you would pick up. Well, you wouldn't purchase Michael Owen to be sort of dribbling with. He is basically a pace freak, and that is all that he's good at. So yeah, if you are going to be using him with the off the ball dribbling, like when you tap the no touch dribbling, sorry, and you get that extra burst of acceleration, then you are getting the full effect out of Michael Owen. Then he becomes useful, and you can commit a few more players, you can create space, and when defenders are on the back foot and Michael Owen's running at you, that acceleration is deadly. But when he gets in front of goal, this was the most frustrating thing. So at times you would expect him to score and easily finesse it past the keeper. No, the keeper would save it. And then when you don't think he's going to score, he absolutely bangs it in. So he's very temperamental in front of goal. His long shots weren't the best either. So yeah, he was a very frustrating card to use. Linking up though, definitely I would use him up top with another striker. On his own, he just really didn't suit the game. Probably the game mechanics, like back in the day he used to like partner up top with Heskey, so I guess that's correct then. Use him up top with them with another striker, and overall I'm gonna have to give the card a 7.5 out of 10, and a value for coins of around, I'm gonna give him a 5 out of 10 for value for coins, because 600k is a lot, but still I would probably value him for around 300k or so, because he's still like, he's good in front of goal really, but it was just, I was expecting a little bit more with the card. But if you have enjoyed my review and want to see any more, drop a like on the video, and I will see you on the next one. Team out. Peace.